Okay, so like I said, welcome again. This is Blessed FS Academy. I'll be showing you how to create an account on your phone, okay, using an Android phone. Like I said, I'll be using an Android phone for this. So I uninstalled my MT4 app and I downloaded it again. Why? Because I wanted, you know, to show you guys how to do everything from the scratch. So if you tap on these three lines here by the left, it will ask you to, you know, you will tap on it and you see that automatically once you download the MT4, automatically they will give you a MetaTrader 4 Android demo, okay, which is a broker, but we are not going to be using it because it's just a default broker. We want to create our own. So we can tap on manage account to open another account. So this sign is sign of demo. Anybody that is showing you his trading results should, once he screenshot it and you are seeing real, that means it's a real account. So this is a demo account, okay? So now you can see that automatically they gave us 100,000 USD to practice with. Do you understand? Now a demo account and a real account is the same thing. The only difference is the money. Both the charts is the same thing. The way the market is moving, exactly the same. Okay, so let's go on. Now you tap that plus sign. Once you tap on it, you can open a demo account, okay, from this MetaTrader 4 with any broker of your choice, or you will go to the broker's website, create an account with them and log into the account, okay? Once you create an MT4 account with a broker, they will allow you to log in with it. They will give you your username and your password to use in logging in, okay? So, but we are going to just search for any broker. Now, let's use FXTM ECN account. So, we'll just search for FXTM. You can see. Then we will choose ECN0 account. ECN0, the second one, okay? Once we tap on it, it will open. They're asking us to put name, to put every other thing that we need to put. Now, you will go ahead and fill these ones, okay? Fill. You can use a false email and, you know, it's just for practice, so you don't need to use your real details. Just make sure you fill anything and make sure it is correct. This part should be numbers, this part should be characters and the likes, okay? So, like I said, I installed this MT4 just for this class, okay, so that, because if I had used mine, you would have seen so many accounts logged in already. So I wanted it to be just like yours. So you choose the account type. If you tap on account type, you choose the currency. You can choose Naira, but let's use USD. The leverage, you can set leverage from here. Let's use 1 to 100. I usually advise 1 to 100. Deposit. Let's say they should give us $3,000 virtual money. You click on create account, okay? Let me quickly fill something here. Blessed FX for the number 09090331604. For the distinct, let's just use something. If you use your email, they might be sending you mails later on. Stuff like that. If you don't want that, just use any mail of your choice. Click on create account. Done. Look at the password, look at the login details. You can screenshot it and go about to use it later to log in. But there's no need, it's a practice account, yeah? You click on done and you've already created an account with that. So now you might not see some of the pairs you want. You tap here to edit the pairs that you want. Once you tap on it, you'll be able to, you will see more pairs to add, okay? You tap on the plus sign. Once you tap on the plus sign, you will see FX Major is a folder. You can choose any pair here which you want to be showing. Let's tap on USDJPY. Okay, that's it. EURGBP is also popular. Once you tap on it, it will go to the front page. You can press back, then you will see it. If you are not getting it, you can take your time again to go through it. So you can see that now, if we tap on these lines again to check the demo that is logged in, once you tap on it, you will see that FXTM is now logged in, okay? FXTM is now logged in. You can tap on manage account. You see that we can also switch to this former one or switch to this one, okay? You understand? So that is it. Now, if you open your chart, normally RSI indicator will be there, which is an indicator. We'll soon get to how to use indicators and strategies and the likes. But for now, we are stopping here, okay? So tomorrow, we'll look at analysis and how to play straight. On Friday, we'll look at how to use the analysis to play straight. So, thank you so much.